In this video, we will discuss about the KA map, which is nothing but a Karnaugh map. Here, I am going to discuss about the simplification of Boolean expression using two variables in this Karnaugh map method. Hello everyone, you are watching New Knowledge In channel. If you like this video, click the subscribe button, click bell button to get updates about the upcoming videos. We'll move on to the video now. Is used to minimize the number of logic gates you need to implement a circuit. Karnaugh map introduces the method of simplification of Boolean functions in an easier way. Otherwise, we have to go for the Boolean postulates, which is a complex method. K-map is a graphical method which consists of 2 power n cells for n variables. N variable in the sense n input variables. The adjacent cells are divided by single bit position. Rules for designing the K-map. The first one is select the K-map according to the number of variable. So the number of input variable n is equal to 2 means 2 power n. So 4 boxes like that. That is the first step. And find out the min terms or max terms as given in the problem. For SOP, for sum of product, put ones in blocks of K-map in the min terms position and in remaining places put 0. For POS, that is for product of sum, put zeros in the blocks of K-map in the max term position and in remaining places put 0. For more information about the product of sum, you can refer the product of sum video. Make rectangular groups by combining the blocks in powers of 2, like 2, 4, 8. You can combine 2 blocks or 4 blocks or 8 blocks and try to cover as many elements as you can in one group. It can be combined in a horizontal manner or in vertical manner. Then you have to solve the final expression. So two variable K-map. The number of cells in two variable K-map is 4, which is nothing but 2 power 2, since the number of variables is 2. Each cell within the K-map has a definite place value, which is obtained by using encoding technique called gray code. So gray code is an important method, and using that method only we are going to label the rows and columns. And each and every boxes should differ at least by 1 bit. So two variable K-map in SOP. In sum of product, we have to fill it by the small m, which is min term. M0, M1, M2 and M3 are the 4 boxes. So this is K-map design. And A and B are the 2 input variables. And this is of 2 variables, so we have 4 boxes. 0 and 1 are written at the top, and 0 and 1 I have written in the vertical position also. The first box is said to be M0, second box is M1, third box is M2, fourth box is M3. And the truth table is designed like AB are the inputs with the 2 variables. So the truth table will be of 4 combinations: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And the min terms are identified as M0, 1, 2, and M3. And here in this table, the first box is for M0 and M1 and then M2, M3. Row wise I am reading now. And your first row is for A dash and second dash is A. As we discussed, as per the gray code, each boxes should differ at least by 1 bit. And in the vertical ones as assigned as B dash and B. So first value is taken as a B dash, that is 0 and then 1. And if you see in the first cell, first box, the combination will be of 00. 00 is M0, min term M0, which will have the value like A dash B dash. The second box is M1, which is having a value 01, which is nothing but A dash B. Next box is M2, A B dash, and M3 is A B, which is 11 value in the truth table. K-map are sum of products and product of sums. So AB are the input variable, B dash B and A dash A, and in boxes I have filled the values. So the first box is A dash B dash, second one is A dash B, next in vertical one A B dash, and last value is AB. In product of sum method, we have to use the plus symbol, which is a max term. So B, B dash are there. B is given as a 0 and B dash is indicated as 1. And that is a max term, and A dash A, the true value is identified by 0 and complemented value is identified as 1. So you have to write in the first cell like A plus B, which is the max term for that cell. And the next is 0-1 combination is A plus B dash. Then 1-0 combination is A dash plus B. 1-1 combination is A dash plus B dash. So these are the methods of writing the K-map for sum of products and product of sums. Next, we have different methods of grouping. The first one is a pair. The grouping of two ones or zeros in horizontal or vertical form is said to be the pair, and those cells can be combined. So if you have two adjacent ones, you can combine that. Next, ways of grouping as a pair. We have taken a problem here with the values I'm giving in the table like 0, 111, and I have entered the values in the boxes like 0, 1, 1, 1. So in 0, 0 combination, the value is 0, 0, 1 is 1, 1, 0 is 1, and 1, 1 is 1. So in the K-map, I have designed like this. And finally, we are grouping the numbers like vertically. Two boxes I am combining, A dash and A. So B is common over there, so you can directly take and write in the output like B. And for the horizontal one, 1-0 and 1-1, A is common over there, and B dash and B are differing. So you can take the constant term, which is not at all changing, as the answer. So A plus B will be the answer for this problem. Thank you. Hope you understand this clearly. We'll see the next video. Please subscribe the channel.